With 9 million dog owners in Britain today, many of them are battling to be top dog at home.
Look, you can't go behind me.
But one man believes there's no such thing as a naughty dog.
I'm not going near it.
Just struggling owners.
Somsy, enough!
You think you've got a problem now, and you have. You're really not in control.
And that's when master dog trainer Graeme Hall steps in to take on the nation's dog owners.
I've worked with almost every breed of dog and all kinds of dog behaviour problems, but 9 times out of 10, it's the owners that need to change their behaviour, and that is a really tough message to get across. The problem I got with you is what you're not doing is any sort of correction at all.
With 12 years' experience, Graham has been put to the test thousands of times.
Come on, let's run.
And the results speak for themselves.
No.
Well done, Fifi.
Well done.
Honestly, it'll change my life.
In Graham's casebook this week, a trip to Nottinghamshire where a small dog with a big attitude has no respect for his owners.
And that hurt. That really did hurt.
Apart from the baby of the family. In Bury, pup Teddy's inability to listen...
Teddy! This is where my blood pressure starts to rise.
..is pushing his owner's patience to the limit.
Teddy, come here!
He's just not listening at all.
But for Graham's first challenge, he's heading to Maidstone to meet an anti-social red setter.
No, Chewie, come on, it's Norman!
3-year-old Chewie hates anyone coming anywhere near his family.
As soon as somebody he doesn't see on a regular basis or doesn't know, a delivery, anybody comes to the door, we have this every single time. He's like literally just watches, he's like a watchdog.
Chewie, quiet!
Chewie feels it's his role to protect them from anyone he sees as a threat.
There's like a switch in him. And I think if you didn't have a hold of him, I definitely think he would go for someone. My biggest fear would be that he'd bite someone and then someone says he has to be put down. That is my ultimate fear.
But it's daughter Aurelia who really suffers.
My daughter can't have her boyfriend round. He just doesn't like having him in the house.
Chewie, it's Ben. Come on, it's Ben. Chewie, he's coming in.
I definitely think Chewie is like, she's mine, so I will protect her.
Chewie, enough.
I think he kind of feels that if anyone comes into his house, everyone's going to like hurt his family. So he gets a bit territorial over us and he's not really protective over us. So he barks quite a lot and that tries to show us how he's protecting us, I think.
Chewie's behaviour inside is only the tip of the iceberg.
You know them. Chewie, stop now. Chewie, enough.
He's not a vicious dog for us. He isn't. He's just way too protective, I suppose.
Come on.
But there may be a good reason behind his protective nature.
The reason we got Chewie was my husband died suddenly 2 days before Christmas in December 2016. We'd previously talked, me and my husband and the kids, about getting a rescue dog, and my friend said to me, why don't you get a puppy? She said it'd be a good distraction, and I was like, OK, yep.
Having joined this family to help them through their grief...
It's all right, baby.
The thought of giving him up is too much to bear.
This dog's seen me at my worst. He's seen me at my when I'm most upset, and he's always been there for me. He's the only good thing that's ever come out of the bad situation. I don't think I want to think what the next step is if he can't be helped. I can't have something bad happen to him. So it's like, I think it just stops me thinking what the next step is, because if he is bad, then someone's going to say, right, that's it, you've got to put him down. And I can't deal with that.
Irish setters were bred in Ireland, not surprisingly, back in the 1800s and before then for hunting. And they're also known as red setters. That's a translation from the Gaelic name for the breed. It's quite unusual to hear about an Irish setter being aggressive. It's not unheard of, but normally they're really good with people. I need to find out what's going on.
Nervous about Graham's visit, Elaine has Chewie in a muzzle, just in case.
Hello. He's not happy, is he? Nice to meet you.
Hi.
Elaine,
hi.
Hi. Hi. This is come in.
Carter and Aurelia.
Carter, really, hi.
Hi.
Nice to meet you. And this is Chewie, obviously.
This is Chewie, yeah.
Okay, so tell me about your problems.
Got a few. Got indoors, if anybody like knocks at the door or walks past, he goes mental. He runs to the window, he barks. If I have a friend round, he like growl and bark and jump at them.
Right.
He is ultra protective of us. He doesn't want anybody in the house unless he knows him really, really well.
And he's just barking at that point, is he?
Yeah.
So,
yeah, barking, yeah. Growling. Jumping if he could as well.
I mean, a muzzle's a good thing because it means you can practice things safely, of course. Yeah. So that's good. Okay, so you know, tell me why you got Chewie.
We got Chewie because December 16, I walked out the door with my youngest son. The two were at home. Came back to find my husband not breathing. He died. Completely unexpected. Wasn't expecting it.
So it started in horrible circumstances.
Yeah.
But as far as dog behaviour is concerned, it all started as a normal kind of puppyhood, I suppose.
Yeah, he was great. He was really good as a puppy.
Right. So fairly normal. And then he starts to get aggressive with people coming into the house.
Yep.
And you've got a problem outside as well?
Yeah, we've got a few problems outside.
Right.
When he was younger, a black lab went for him.
Right.
And he has held a grudge.
So this problem's getting worse and worse.
It is. We're just escalating at the moment.
Right.
It's not long before Graeme sees how Elaine deals with Chewie's reaction to strangers. When Chewie appears to have calmed down, is he let out of his cage?
It's fine. All right. Chewie, they're gone. They've gone. Chewie, they've gone. That's what we have when the door goes.
Yeah.
And that's without someone even coming in the door.
He's like Jekyll and Hyde dog, isn't he?
He is, completely. Yeah. Total Jekyll and Hyde, yeah.
Elaine thinks she's dealing with the issue by locking Chewie away in a cage, but all it's doing is reinforcing his belief that people who come to the door are bad.
Having seen Chewie's protective behaviour inside, Graeme now wants to see how bad things are on walks.
Right, lady and a dog.
Right.
There's
issues between these two.
Oh, is there?
Right. Yeah.
Well, just show me what you normally do.
Come on, Chew, let's go. Come on, Chew. Chewie. Come on! Chewie! No!
Apparently, he's kind of nemesis, his arch-enemy.
Chewie!
And we can see that he's really kicking off. Now, I'm interested to see Elaine's response, and she's just holding on for dear life, really, and saying, Chewie, no, and calm down. And actually trying to get him to calm down while he's still excited.
Calm down,
actually, she's kind of rewarding the wrong behaviour. Well, that was quite a revelation.
Welcome to my world.
Yeah, I see what you mean. He really is Jekyll and Hyde, isn't he?
Yeah.
Okay, look, I've seen enough. I think I know what's going on. Let's go back to the house. We'll have a chat.
Okay, sounds good.
Come on, you.
Come on.
The importance of turning Chewie's behaviour round is already weighing heavily on Graham's mind.
One of the things that strikes me so much about this case is that Chewie means so much to this family. He was everything to them after they'd lost, you know, husband and dad and... They can't lose him. They cannot lose him. So it's my job to make sure that we fix this.
Coming up, can Graeme tame Chewie and give Elaine and her family the calm companion they're desperate for him to be?
Hey.
And a chihuahua, whose only respect is for the baby of the family.
He licks her and he loves her, but she's the only one.
Today, Graham's in Maidstone to tame an overprotective red setter who was bought after owner Elaine's husband sadly passed away. Graeme has seen firsthand how Chewie's behaviour is affecting his family, and he thinks he knows what's going on.
One of the things that I've noticed is that you're trying to calm him down while he's still in that very excited state.
Yeah.
Your voice is all a bit wrong, Elaine. So, so you're either trying to calm him down, which sounds almost like praise.
Yep.
The sound, not the words.
Yeah.
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 Or sometimes when you're out and about, I know your voice is very, you're stressed out. So it's like, no, Chewie. And it's just like fueling the fire.
Okay, yep.
So we need to work on your tone of voice. One of the features of the way things are outside, actually, this walks all on his terms. From the very moment you leave the house, he's just controlling your walk.
Yeah.
He's put himself in charge. So what happens when you meet somebody, he's kind of going, right, stand back, mother, I'll deal with this, but he doesn't know how to do it.
Yeah.
So we've put him in charge of the walk, but he's not the right one to be in charge of the walk. You are.
Yeah. If I'm honest, I think he dictates, who comes in the house.
Yeah.
If he likes them, he'll let them in the house.
Right.
If we're out, if he likes a dog, that's fine. He'll let us talk to them type thing. But it is literally everything's on his terms.
Yeah. A bit like a spoiled child, really. I get that Chewie felt that he needed to protect the family when they first got him because they were in a vulnerable place. But the key to solving this is for the family to show him that they don't need protection. But that means that they have to show that people aren't a threat, and that takes confidence.
Graeme wants to start the training in a controlled environment inside the house.
So, I'm only going to make a couple of small changes, and I think they might have a big effect. I noticed before when Chewie's barking and lunging at the window, you're behind him. So you're kind of trying to lead from behind, which doesn't make sense, really. So the thing to do is to get up and get between him and the window, so to block him, in effect, and then get him to move back.
Yeah.
If he tries to sidestep you,
then
you just need to keep your cool and go, I think so.
Sounds good.
Graeme wants to show Elaine that by getting in between Chewie and what he perceives to be a threat, they're showing him that there is no danger and that they are in control. So he's arranged for someone to help by delivering parcels.
Hey! No. Off! Good boy. Off. Boy.
Using a firm command.
Hey, off.
And when Chewie calms, prays.
Good boy.
This setter quickly settles down.
That's good.
He kind of, stopped so much quicker than what I expected. He normally is like, rah, rah, and he'd go on and on and on.
Yeah.
But it was almost instantaneously that he just stopped.
And the biggest difference is that block. There you go.
No.
Off.
Good boy.
That's it. Keep an eye on him. Well, that's good, look.
Good boy.
Yeah, don't rev him up. Nice and calm with your praise. Yeah. Good boy. Well, he's not barking now, look. Well done. Pretty much as quick as when I did.
I know. Good boy.
Congratulations, you're in control of your dog.
Elaine may be in control when there's a barrier between Chewie and a visitor, but how will he fare when he comes face to face with a stranger?
Good boy. Hey, no.
Off!
In front.
Off!
Off!
Off! Off! Off! Off!
Wait for it. So you're off, so a bit shouty. Yeah. Listen. Off! Good boy. So the block was right, that bit was right.
Yep.
But you were
the
actually.
The way I said it. Yeah.
The way you said it was wrong because you were fueling the fire.
Okay.
Yeah.
Off, off, off. Yep.
As soon as I stepped in, I went off.
Right. Okay. Yep.
Gotcha.
Yes.
You know? I know this will work. It's just a case of reassuring Chewie that people coming to the door aren't a threat. But that can only happen if Elaine can project a calm confidence with her voice.
So Graeme wants to really put her to the test. He's invited Aurelia's boyfriend Ben over, as Chewie's protectiveness goes into overdrive when he comes around.
Ben's due any time. Now, you said you've only ever had him round to the house twice in 10 months. Yeah?
Yeah.
How bad was it last time?
He just goes chaotic, really. He's very barky, very aggressive.
Right. Protect you from this boy.
Yeah.
Very good. Okay. So, I think what we'll do is, if we go to the living room, we'll wait for Ben to come in.
Okay.
You're in charge.
Yep.
Right?
Okay.
So just before we let Ben in, remember to stay calm but be really firm.
Yep.
Don't let your voice get panicky, even if you're feeling panicky.
Yep.
And remember that blocking thing. Hello, Ben, come in.
Ben.
Grab a seat.
You all right?
Hey.
Oh!
Wait for it.
Oh! Oh!
Keep going.
Oh! Oh.
Wait oh. for it.
But as Chewie's protective oh. mode kicks in...
Oh! 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 Oh!
Elaine's confidence crumbles.
Hey, off. He just needed a bit of extra help. So let's not tense up on this.
OK.
Because then he's just going to fight against
right.
it.
OK.
I'm going to sit down and let's do that again then.
Yeah, I know.
And this time with a confident off command...
Off! Off!
..and a firm block, Elaine eventually calms Chewie right down.
How's this compared to normal then?
It's a lot better, Phil. Less scared in the room with him.
So, what's beginning to happen, you see, is that he's gone from, right, you lot all need protecting, let me do it, even though he doesn't know what he's doing, to you actually saying, actually, I'm your mother, listen to me, I know best.
Graeme may have got him to calm down in the house, but Chewie's biggest problem is outside.
Well, I'm really pleased, but it's not lost on me that I need to come back and do the outside training. And a lot hangs on that. If we get that wrong, we could potentially rub out all the good work we've done today.
While Graeme leaves Elaine to work on her confidence, he's going to Nottinghamshire to meet a little dog with a big attitude who's lost all respect for his owners.
Shall we tie my shoes?
4-year-old Chihuahua Joey thinks he has the right to anything in the house.
For some strange reason, he likes to guard things.
So when he does this with his little lip and his teeth, you know not to go any further because he will bite you.
1 second. Take the treat.
And that hurt. That really did hurt.
Tracy and Vince have two very different approaches, from distracting with treats...
You either throw a toy or you throw something.
..to confronting him head-on. He may terrorise the owners of the house, but one person he respects is 18-month-old granddaughter, Harriet.
But for some reason, with Harriet, he will play with her, she can take toys with him, off him, give them back to him, and he loves her.
In fact, Joey loves her so much, he guards her with his life.
So he's just guarding Harriet now? Yeah, absolutely. The minute we brought Harriet home from the hospital, he guarded her straight away. Put her in a Moses basket. She was crying. We couldn't get her out of the Moses basket.
But Joey's obsession with Harriet is now so extreme, he won't let Tracy and Vince anywhere near her. And they can't enjoy being grandparents.
People say they're animals, but they're part of your life. It's part of our little family. But we're just desperate now, aren't we?
So can Graeme put a stop to this tiny terror's aggressive guarding?
Chihuahuas are the very smallest of dog breeds, but don't be fooled by their small stature, because they've been called the warrior dogs, because they really fiercely protect what they think is theirs. Hello.
Oh,
hello, you. Hello. You're not happy, are you? Hello, nice to meet you.
Hello, hi, Graeme, nice to meet
you. Tracy, is it? Hello.
It's Tracy, yeah.
Come on, you.
Come on.
No sooner has he arrived, Graeme sees exactly what Joey's problem is.
Harriet, what are you doing?
Okay, what's happening?
Oh, Harriet.
Ah.
So I'm trying to get Harriet off there because she's going to fall anyway.
Right.
Sit. Harriet, it's not funny. Naughty.
Say away.
Tell Joey no.
Hello.
Harriet, say no to Joey.
Doesn't help, does it?
That doesn't help at all.
No.
Come on, sweetie.
How bad can this get?
Well, it's pretty bad. All she's got to do is fall, and this is my concern now, she's this age.
Yeah.
Because if she was to fall forward, but I can't protect her, so I have to try and ask her to come to me.
Right.
It's just a devil dog when it behaves like this.
Yeah. Shall we go through?
Hello, hi. Right, shall we grab a seat then?
Yeah.
So, well, you're not very happy, are you?
No, not happy at all.
Nice.
He mainly guards Harriet, but he also guards anything. Car keys, you can't get them off him. Glasses, anything.
Right.
And he's getting worse. He seems to let Harriet do anything. She could take anything out of his basket, take anything out of his mouth, but anybody else. To be fair, if he's got something and we say to Harriet, can we have that? And she goes to get it, he lets her have it straight away.
How does that make you feel?
Well, we keep falling out, don't we? Because
we don't know our best to discipline
him. We don't know how to do it, how to discipline it. We've both got different ideas.
Okay.
I'd say ignore him and walk away if we don't need to do anything. And you say you need a firm hand and show him who's boss.
Yeah, yeah.
We're a bit stuck, really.
So if you tried to take that dolly away from Harriet now, what would happen? So.
No, he's lifting his... he's going to bite me.
Warning signs are there, look.
Yes. But if Harriet gives it to me...
Right. That's interesting. So if Harriet decides, he's kind of... OK,
quite
then.
Quite cute with it, yeah.
Right.
It's ridiculous.
Him or Harriet haven't said yes. That's interesting. Yeah, yeah.
Graham needs to witness how both Tracy and Vince retrieve items from their territorial terror. With Joey guarding a pair of glasses, Vince demonstrates how he tackles this possessive pooch with his usual technique, the feather duster.
Just... I'm with you, yeah. So you create a big fight.
Yeah.
And then use that to lure the fight away. Yeah. And then you grab the glasses. Oh. But Tracy, how was that making you feel?
Really nervous.
You look terrified.
Because I'm worried when we're doing things like this that we're making him into a frenzy and he's going to end up biting me as well in the process. So if he's guarding something that we really need to get, I get a tree and dangle it in front of his nose and throw it. And when he runs, get what it is.
Yeah. Right, well, I've seen enough. I've really understood the problem, I think. So let's have a cup of tea and I'll let you in on the secret.
Oh, can't wait.
So if two-year-old Harriet is the only person in this house that can take things off Joey, then it kind of begs a question. Why? What's Harriet got? Well, it's more what Harriet hasn't got, and that's fear. She's so young that she's not learnt yet to be fearful. She's not scared. And Joey picks up on that and just says, OK, I'll give you whatever you want. So what I need to happen is that the rest of this family learn to be like Harriet and channel their inner child. They need not to be so scared, and then we're on a winner. The thing is, that's easier said than done.
Coming up, can Graham get this cheeky chihuahua to respect his owners?
Wait for it. Same principle.
And in Berry, he's to tackle a cavapouchon who just doesn't listen.
It really frightens me to think that he could get lost.
In Nottinghamshire, having observed Tracy and Vince's lack of control over Chihuahua Joey,
Harriet, sit,
and his devotion for their granddaughter Harriet,
Harriet, it's not funny.
Graham knows exactly where the problem lies.
So, first of all, question for you. Who's in charge in this house, then?
Me.
Are you sure? Mm.
Joey.
Actually, I don't think it is. I think it's Harriet.
Really?
As far as Joey's concerned.
Yeah.
Because she's the only one that can take things off him.
Yeah.
And I think the reason for that is that she hasn't learned fear yet. She's of an age where they're completely fearless.
Yeah.
So when she says no and grabs something, he just goes, oh, yeah, okay. You know?
Yeah.
So I think there's a lesson in that. You need to learn to be a little bit fearless. So I've got to make sure that you're doing the right thing. And we need to put some training in place.
Graham believes the key to curing Joey's behaviour is getting him to respect Vince and Tracy in the same way he respects Harriet and her fearlessness.
This dog will only respect them if they show him the rules. And Joey needs to understand what's acceptable, and then he'll be rewarded when he complies. So I'm going to use a simple off command, but at the same time, I'm going to move Joey off using a physical barrier, just so that the message gets through. So if I went to get that now, he's already showing teeth, he's going to look at me, right? So if I went to get that, if he did that, I could use this extension to my hand just to go, no, off. It's a barrier between him and the phone. Off. off. Ah, good boy.
Praising Joey tells him that this behaviour is acceptable.
Now he's down there. You see, he sort of changed, his eyes have changed a bit. Mm. Good boy. I can pick that up now.
Yeah.
Once Joey starts to respect his owners, Graeme thinks they will no longer need to use the folder as a barrier.
Ah, good boy. What did you see about my body language? How would you describe it?
Very confident. Not scared at all.
That's what I'm after.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The key is not to back down and show fear. But can Tracy hold her nerve?
Wait for it. Same principle. So, wait.
Off.
Good lad, that's fine. Now move him away a bit. That's it, block, that's it. So you're using it as a barrier. Now if you step towards him, that's it.
Joey, off.
With a clear off and the folder used as a barrier to reinforce the command...
Now he's walked off.
Goodbye.
The message is sinking in.
Now you could take your right hand and pick them up gently. How's that feel?
Great.
Good.
Well, I feel better because I don't feel like we're doing what Vince normally does and having a big, massive fight with him.
Yes.
And I don't feel like I'm trying to give him a treat to get him away. So I did feel much better.
And the more you do it, the more he gets the message, right?
Yeah.
Joey may have responded to Tracy, but can Vince get him to respect his command?
Off. Going nowhere, Joey.
Yeah. Keep moving him backwards. Don't talk too much. That's it.
Off. Off.
That's it. As he takes a step,
good boy.
That's when he's saying off. Good boy. Now, if you take your folder away, what's he doing? Right, move back towards him and say off.
Off.
That's it. Physically move into him with your feet.
Off.
That's it. That's it. Guide him away.
Off.
Guide him away.
Off, Joey.
That's it.
Strong.
Not strong as you.
Off. Good lad.
Ah, but that didn't sound like praise. Good lad, off. It's all of it, yeah? It's all the same. So your praise needs to be a bit more. Good boy.
Right. Good boy.
That's it. Now. Ah.
With Vince off. Showing no fear.
That's it. Wait for it. This is very off. Different, isn't it? He's not attacking, is he?
Not attacking.
It's a breakthrough.
Good boy. Look, he's even sat for you.
Joey is finally respecting his owner and is rewarded with affection.
So if you give me that folder now, you could give him a gentle little tickle. He's turned into a good boy, and you can pick up your wallet.
Good lad. There you go.
And we didn't need that in the end.
No.
How did that feel, though?
A lot better, yeah.
For 18 months, Vince and Tracy have struggled to get anywhere near Joey's most prized possession, granddaughter Harriet. But after 4 hours and with Joey finally learning his place, the family can relax and enjoy sharing a sofa.
How do you feel now, just sat there with Harriet?
I feel so much better because I know now if he does start, one of us could get up and we could use the technique and we could stop him almost straight away. Mm. So instead of having a battle and a fight with him.
Yeah. Well, we've taken the fight right out of it.
Definitely.
And the more you practice with him guarding objects, the more that transfers to her. Well done, everybody. I think you've done a great job. So put it there.
Cheers,
so congratulations.
Thank you.
Bye-bye, you. So all the best.
Thank you.
All right.
Sitting here now with him really calm, it's like having a different dog. And this is the type of dog we wanted, you know, a dog that we could love and have part of our family. So it's great.
Now, we've had a great result today, but of course, there's still work to do. So this family aren't really out of the woods. But if they keep practicing, that'll improve and improve. And I think they'll end up with a very nice dog indeed.
Graeme has worked with every type of dog breed, from the largest to the smallest. But with more and more designer dogs being bred, Graeme's discovered that with a mix of traits can come trouble, as Kelly and her family from Bury have discovered.
Teddy! Teddy! Teddy!
This 18-month-old Cavapoo-Shon has one aim in life, to run.
Teddy!
And run.
Teddy!
And run.
Teddy, this way.
Teddy!
and there's no chance of getting him back.
He's just not listening at all. He's just doing what he wants to do.
Teddy!
Busy mum Kelly bought Teddy to bring her and her three children closer together after a relationship breakdown. But this chaotic canine is actually coming between them.
I think the children might agree with me is that when we're out and about, yeah. I don't really pay much attention to them because it's all focused on Teddy.
And Teddy's inability to listen is leaving this family terrified of the consequences.
It really frightens me to think that he could get lost. If he just runs that one direction too far, you know, goes the wrong way, he could be gone in a shot. And then what would we do? Be devastated.
I've worked with quite a few Cavapoochons now because they're quite popular. You know, they're one of those sort of designer crossbreeds. And they were kind of designed, if you can call it that, to look like puppies forever. So they're really cute. Scary, terrifying dog. Oh, hello.
Hello.
Hello. Kelly.
Hi,
nice to meet you. All right.
Yes, thank
you. Hello, you. Hello.
Kelly, come on.
Go, he's keen, isn't he?
Come on.
Hello, hello. Go on. Come in on, you go. Good lad. So why a Cavapoochon then?
A Cavapoochon, so I looked into my breeds because I wanted a small enough one for the kids to just, you know, have as a pet, a cuddle, to be able to cuddle and yeah. Just not too big, just something small, fluffy and cute.
Right, yeah. So yeah. You bought a dog that was cute, really, didn't you?
Yes.
Kelly may have fallen for this dog's good looks, right. But when it comes to training him to come back to her, she's missed the mark.
So yeah, I need him to just be able to hear my voice, listen to what I say, and follow my commands. And
you wouldn't think that was so hard, would you, really? But
well, it's impossible for me. I feel like it's impossible.
Needing to see just how excitable this pup is, it's off to the park. And no sooner are they there than Teddy is up to his old tricks.
There we go.
Teddy! 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 Teddy!
Oh, he always does it.
So what do you normally do?
I just try and call him, but I have to run over to get him.
Go on,
he
then.
Just won't... Teddy! Teddy! Come here. Come here, Teddy. Teddy. Right. Come here. Teddy. Teddy.
There you go.
Teddy. Oh, hello. Lead back on you, mister.
Sorry about that.
Sorry. Sorry.
What's it feel like to have an out-of-control dog?
Not nice. All I can say, he's lucky he's so cute.
Yeah, I think you're right. I think you are very lucky that he's a cute little dog, because he'll get away with it with a lot of people, you know.
Yes.
If he was a Rottweiler, bounding up to people, it would be a very different story.
Absolutely.
Well, this isn't the first time I've come across an owner who thinks that just by calling a dog's name, they're automatically going to come back. Dogs aren't pre-programmed to return when you call them, and Kelly might as well be just shouting, Teddy, run, Teddy, run. I need to go back to basics, and I need to teach Teddy what we want him to do when we actually call him. But it's not going to be easy, because he's now 18 months old. I don't think we should just let him off and hope for the best, because I haven't got a magic command for you. But what I do have is a long line. So the reason for the long line is primarily that he actually can't escape and get away from us. We can also send him a little signal through the long line by going, oi, you.
Okay.
And we also need a nice clear command. Teddy
here. Yeah.
And then we'll see what happens. If he comes back, great, fantastic, we should reward him.
Yes.
So when I say it, it's nice and bright, you know, and there's a little gap in between. So, Teddy, here, like okay, that. So, ba-bum, bum.
Yeah.
Right? Quite bright and exciting, that.
Yeah.
So, let's have a little practice. Do you want to try that?
Yeah, okay. Right. Teddy here.
Yeah, or even a bit...
Teddy, right. Here?
Yeah, that's it. And when you do it for real, it needs to be really loud.
Right, like okay.
People in Bolton can hear you.
Right, yeah.
So that's what we need.
Okay.
So, good.
By using a clear command...
Teddy, here!
...and giving a gentle tug on the lead towards him, Teddy understands what he's supposed to do.
Good boy.
Now it's Kelly's turn, but will her voice be enough to get Teddy back?
Call him now, look.
Teddy! Teddy! Here! Here!
Yay!
Good boy.
So you went, Teddy! Teddy! Here! No, you're getting close to your old-fashioned
yeah.
Teddy, Teddy, Teddy. Right,
should
so
just be a...
Teddy, here, every right. time. If that doesn't work, okay, we give him a flick. Maybe
okay.
we call him again, but...
Yeah.
don't get back into your old habit, no, because that definitely ain't going to work.
Go out the window, yeah.
That's it.
Go on, let's go.
I call him.
Teddy!
And with another flick on the long lead and Kelly's excited voice, he's finally understanding what's expected of him.
Good boy! Fantastic. Well done!
Your tone of voice sounds so much better now.
Yes.
Instead of it being this panicky, Teddy, 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 it's like, Teddy, yeah.
And Kelly's eldest son, Ashai, turns up just in time.
Ashai, nice to meet you, mate.
To see his mum and Teddy really be put to the test. Graeme wants to see if the command has sunk in and if Teddy will recall when there's a playmate to distract him.
Right, nice and bright, your voice.
Teddy, here!
Fantastic! Well done!
Well done! Oh,
well done!
Amazing.
There you
Thank
go,
you.
That was fantastic.
Oh, brilliant, high five! Yeah!
Brilliant. So what do you think, Ashai?
I think she's doing well on that and Teddy can listen now.
I know, it's amazing, isn't it?
He is
it?
Listening, isn't he? That's
he
the point.
He is listening, yes. Yeah.
So you've used the right tone of voice. You've
That's
got
it.
The timing right.
Yes.
You're praising him now when he gets it right. And we're using the long line not to drag him back, but just to send a signal occasionally if
yes.
you need to.
Yes.
And it means he can't run away. Teddy is responding to a voice command, but he still needs a little flick on the lead just to reinforce it. But I believe that in time, he will come back when he's off lead. And if you keep practicing, you're going to end up with a dog who's really well behaved that you can be proud of.
Amazing. Just
Great.
What we wanted, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Just what we wanted.
Brilliant. Well done.
Fantastic. Thank you.
You're
Thank
more than welcome.
Thank you. Well done. Yeah!
Graeme may have helped Teddy obey a command, but in Maidstone there's more work to do. To get Chewie, the overprotective pooch, under control, out on walks.
Chewie! Chewie! No! Come on! Chewie! No! No!
It's coming to the end of another busy working week. But Graeme has one final job to complete in Maidstone with Elaine's red setter Chewie, who she got to help with her grief after the loss of her husband.
Chewie, quiet!
On his last visit, Graeme taught Elaine how to calm Chewie's overprotective aggression towards visitors.
Hey, I'm interested to find out how Elaine's got on with Chewie, and I'm quietly confident that she should have been able to keep control of Chewie in the house. Unless something's gone drastically wrong, we'll find out. Hello.
Hello, morning.
Hello. This is different.
This is
nice to see you again.
Come on, Chewie.
Well, that was a lot quieter
I
than
know.
Last time.
I know.
Great. So, how's it gone then?
Excellent. It's like a different dog. We've had a few friends round, and they even got to stroke him last night.
Uh-huh.
So, And they got to see the affectionate side that we have of Chewie.
Great. Well, today we need to build on that and go outside and transfer that learning to the outside world. And,
yep.
And I think there are some common threads, essentially you being in charge of things rather than him.
Yes.
So should we get togged up and go?
Perfect. Looking forward to it.
Great. There you go. What I noticed last time was that Chewie really walks you. So when he stops, you stop.
Yep.
When he goes, you go.
Mm-hmm.
Even direction-wise, you go his direction sometimes.
Just follow him.
You do, in effect. Yeah. So we're going to change all that around. So I want you to walk with another dog.
OK.
But, you know, at a reasonable distance that there's good control.
OK.
And if that's going well, we should get nearer and nearer and nearer until you walk in parallel with another dog.
OK.
And let's see how that feels.
Sounds good. I like the plan.
Just like in the house, Elaine needs to prove to Chewie that she doesn't need protecting. She is the one in charge. And it's all about using that newfound confidence. Now, for now, we're keeping the muzzle on for Elaine's peace of mind, but hopefully that can be removed as her confidence grows. So I've asked your neighbour, Richard, to come along. He's brought his son's dog.
OK.
And this is Winston. Now, Winston's quite reactive.
Yep.
Hence why he wears the muzzle himself.
OK.
If we do get a reaction, then you know what to do.
Right, I do.
Right? So. Bring your leg into play, block, the right body language, the right tone of voice with your off, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Wait for him to stop reacting. When he stops reacting,
praise
good
him.
Boy, nice and gently.
Okay.
3, 2, 1,
Let's
off
go.
You go.
Using the same techniques she learnt in the house.
Bit nearer, bit nearer. Keep walking though. Bit nearer, bit nearer. Keep going.
Good boy. Keep walking.
Keep going.
That's it.
And with her newfound confidence...
Well done. Come on.
Good boy.
Good.
Good boy, Chewie.
Super.
Good boy.
Great.
Well done, Chewie.
Lovely.
Come on, good boy.
Chewie doesn't even bat an eyelid.
No good tension, boy. Remember. Give him a chance.
And for the first time ever, he's walking calmly alongside another dog.
Elaine, come back to me then. Lovely. Thank you very much.
Well done.
Well done, you. Congratulations. That's really good.
Thank you.
I'm really pleased with that. What
That's
about you?
Really good, yeah. Really good. Oh, so proud.
And you remembered everything I said. So as they got nearer and nearer, I could see that he was beginning to go, I'm going to say hello. And you're like, no, not yet. You're not ready. I'll decide, which is quite right. And then finally, you know, I did give you a little hint, which was just the tension. Because it's very difficult. Everything about you screaming, hold on for dear life, and it's the wrong thing to do. But that was fantastic. Tell you what, put it there.
High five.
Chewie.
High five.
High five.
Yay! Good lad.
For nearly 2 years, Chewie's tried to protect the family from anything he sees as a threat. Now the dog they got after an awful loss can be the pet they all enjoy.
Training today has been, it's been amazing. I didn't think I'd be able to come out and walk Chewie next to a dog that before, so it's kind of like, it's the icing on the cake really, that, you know, he can go out and we can enjoy it and enjoy him and actually take him places now, because we wouldn't do that before. So now when we go off somewhere, it's like, yep, let's take Chewie with us. And I feel confident that we can take him on days out with us for like nice long walks and not have to worry so much. So it's a really good thing. It's going to be so good for all of us for the future. Really good.
Can I give you one of these?
Of course you
can. Thank you so much.
Cheers, darling.
Thank you.
Take care of yourself. Well, I wish Elaine all the very best for the future. I think, you know, her and her family can move on now. We've got on top of Chewie's behaviour. He's going to get better and better instead of worse and worse. And there's no doubt in my mind that this dog that's helped them so much in their grief will still be there for them for years and years to come.
In Nottingham, Joey's finally respecting everyone in the family, and Tracy and Vince are enjoying time with their granddaughter, Harriet. Teddy's lead training is going well, and his family are now able to enjoy walks together. And with her newfound confidence, Elaine has Chewie under control. Eventually.